All right, cool. Let me jump in. So my first question is, I want to know, and I want to talk about for young people right now. And again, we're talking about young black men specifically, because we all sort of fall, not sort of, we all fall into that category. I'm probably the only one that's probably sort of fall into that category.
half.
But I'll take it. I'm running with it. Nigeria today. That's it. Here we go.
Black is black.
There we go.
Exactly. I'll spell that.
What factors do you think are causing maybe an increase? What factors do you think just cause problems with mental health in that specific demographic in general? And I want to take out social media for now. I don't want to talk about social media because I feel like that's the first one that we jump to. But what do you think it is, or what do you think is the biggest one, two, three that are causing these type of problems?
I think we've all kind of touched on it, but it's like that concept of, or that alignment with mental illness and weakness, like if you said, do you know what I mean? Like if you've got a mental illness, you're seen as weak, you're seen as subordinate, you're seen as there's something dark about you. Do you know what I mean? When you can literally just be the most average guy, it's just that sometimes you're kind of swayed a little bit easier. Do you know what I mean? Like mental health isn't always as deep as PTSD. Do you know what I mean? It can literally just be something which is under the surface, that just bubbles and bubbles and can literally tip you here and there, and it leaves you kind of unbalanced as you go about your day to day. But to the outside world, you're calm, like you're functioning well. But to you, you know that something's not right. Do you know what I mean? And kind of that battle that people have is an issue with their mental health. It doesn't have to go to an extreme, but then people feel like they don't have the power. They're not able to come out and talk about these things because they know what people are going to judge them as, they know what they're going to be branded as, and I feel like it's that fear and that suppression, the fact that they're then bottling it up, saying, like, well, I can't talk to my mum, like, I can't talk to my mother about this, I can't talk to my father about this, my boys are going to judge me, the world is going to judge me, social media, I know you said we shouldn't touch on it, but that's going to judge me as well, so you know what, I'm going to bottle it up. And I'm going to be fine because it's just a storm and it's going to pass, and then I'm going to move on and I'm going to be cool tomorrow. And then 2 weeks later, the same thing's going to happen. Another 2 weeks, like, same thing's going to happen. 2 days later, the same thing's going to happen. And all you're doing is boiling it up. And then eventually the bottle's going to fill up and it's going to explode. Do you know what I mean? So it's that suppression, which I feel like is a massive, massive thing, and something which we need to work on as a people in terms of them bringing it more to the forefront so people feel more comfortable coming out and speaking to their friends. Do you know what I mean? Like, as much as people say go out and speak to an expert because it helps or whatever, like sometimes like your friends or your kind of the best therapists because they know you better than anyone else, your family know you better than anyone else. Do you know what I mean? So I think that fear that people have not to speak to family or friends needs to really be switched up. Do you know what I mean? That dynamic there needs to be switched up and people need to feel less afraid to come out and talk about their experiences, no matter how small. Nice.
I kind of think Dan's kind of you kind of spoke about it, like how you said when you're feeling a type of way, it's almost like you feel if you don't have a title for how you're feeling, that you're okay, kind of thing. And I think that was a big problem for me because I grew up around a lot of men that kind of had things that were really wrong with them. Like I said, a man was schizophrenic and ADHD and all these things. I kind of saw them and saw I'm not as bad as them. I must be okay, kind of thing. And yeah, so because you kind of have examples around you. Another thing is, well, I kind of thought, I don't want to say I'm feeling a way. It might upset them. The man there, they really have problems. The man just turned to me and be like, what are you talking about? You're having a couple of bad weeks and you think you've got some kind of mental man thing happening. So for me, yeah, definitely. And just the fact that I didn't want to be seen as weak. I didn't want to ask certain people for help. There were people that looked up to me, people that I looked up to, that I didn't want to associate me with just being upset, not even mental health, you get me? Just being upset in general. So I kind of put on a mask when I was in public, when I was with my people, them, around my own family and that. And it would only really be when I was alone that I'd actually think that, rah, I don't feel too sort of. Because I weren't really alone too tough. I didn't really get to figure it out until I could kind of separate myself from everything that was upsetting me. And that took years, man. That took years, so.
The interesting point. Yeah. That sort of suffocation, that when you're around people all the time, there's no time for that sort of like sitting there thinking, wait, am I okay?
That's exactly. And it's like, and again, because I had people around me that blatantly weren't okay, and I was part of me wanting to look out for them and not upset them, and it's just, there's loads of things that kind of hold you back from even admitting it to yourself before you can go to other people and say, yo, you get me? So, yeah, man, it's difficult.
Everything bad, you don't want to add anything.
These two just literally hit nails on the head right now. Like, I don't want to, there's no, that's also another thing that, speaking of like, I always feel like it's all about listening as well, like being a good listener. Like, so right now, it's like, I've met probably Lipsy a few times. I've never met a man you're listening to his music, or sorry, not his music, his spoken words, or it's to have them in the same room as me and speaking about something like as touchy as mental health awareness. Sometimes it's good to be a good listener, because a lot of people don't even have anyone to listen.
Right? Of course.
So it's just like speaking to yourself, and you use other outlets to like for people to listen to you, and then you're still not getting the depth of actually having a proper conversation.
Especially something like mental health, like not everyone's a teacher, none of us here are experts. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Sometimes it's better to just sit down and listen.
Yeah.
From then you can understand what other people's problems are. Maybe from there you can find out what your problems are, what your problems with the people around you as well. But yeah, like Bandman said, like getting the listening is key.
I can honestly say, I don't think this is probably the first conversation I've had face to face with people about my mental health. And that's, and I'll be honest, that's just because I don't really know you, man.
If I did, I'll be honest, I'll probably say the same thing. So it's good to listen,
hear other people's opinions and other people's angles of the thing. Because no one speaks about it, no one. It can always be about someone else or someone that's far gone or something. Something's happened to them and it's blatant and they're going through something.
And I just think the phases of the spoken word narrative, when it is spoken about, are people like me and you, do you know what I mean? It's, we're never at the forefront of the conversation. It's like, we're going to put a white woman in the middle of our poster. And although it's good that the general kind of concept of it is being brought up, but like there's like I said, within mental health, there's so many layers, there's so many different stories. Do you know what I mean? My experience is not the same as everyone else's, so my causes aren't the same as someone from a completely different demographic. Do you know what I mean? So the fact that we're here talking about it as a people, as young black men, which I haven't seen before in kind of this sort of format, is sick. Because it means that then there's certain truths that people can kind of be at home watching and be like, yeah, you know what, I resonate with that. Like, these men are like me and they're brave enough to come out here and speak about it and tell their story. And that means that I'm okay. And if I'm not okay, I know that I'm all right going to tell someone or speak to someone and know that I can be okay. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, now I'm sick still.
That's what I feel, what you said before about balance. I think it's all about balance. Like, in this situation right now, what we're doing now is tipping the balance. From being talkers to listeners as well, and talking about ourselves, that's the balance. It's about talking about yourself. Because you can talk about other people because you know it's not going to affect you.
Yeah, exactly.
But when you talk about yourself and other people are listening about you, that's tipping the balance. Because now you're not talking about outside information that has nothing to do. It's all about inside information that's gonna further better you as a person as well. And that's what I always say, balance is key. And also, like you said, about obviously people are gonna be listening and watching this, and we just said we don't know each other on camera. So the people that are watching this at home with their bedrooms, you know each other, you're next to each other. You can actually turn around to your bedroom and be like, yo, like, are you okay, bro? Like, what's happened in the last few months? Like, you've changed in this way, or this, you're acting different in your focus. You're not focused on you anymore. You're not focused on your music. You're not focused on your work.
Like, saying that, sometimes it's so hard.
I know it's hard
to chat to someone that you know already. Do you know what I mean? Like, sometimes it's easier to chat to a complete stranger.
Yeah.
And then on the other side of the coin, it's so hard to approach someone that you know and love and be like, I feel like there's something wrong with you.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Sometimes that's so hard, just seeing that, and obviously, like, people who are in that situation need to take the responsibility and be like, hey, it's not about me, it's about them. Do you know what I mean?
So it is hard.
It's not easy on either side of the coin to come out to people and to go to people, do you know what I mean, and have that conversation. It's not easy at all.
Let me throw this one out. Why do you think, I think you might have really touched on it, why do you think we find it easier to talk to random people. Not, yeah, why do you find it easier to talk to people that we don't really know that well about what's going on up here than we do people that we know and love? Like, I'll be more inclined if you wanted to sit here and listen to how my mental health has been for the past 21 years, I'll tell you everything you want to know.
Yeah.
But if my mum sat me down and asked me a question, I feel more guarded.
I think it's the judgment element. It's not even just judgment as in they're gonna label me a certain way, but the fact is, if I have this conversation with someone I know today, it's not the first and last time I'm gonna have this conversation. Okay, if I speak to you now, it's probably first and last. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If I speak to my mum now, then she's gonna bring it up the next day. Mm. And the next day. And when I'm feeling good, she's gonna bring it up again and it's gonna come down. Do you know what I mean? So like, it's all these fears. It's the fear that you don't wanna take your burden
and put it on
someone else. Do you know what I mean?
Or hateful that someone to feel worried about.
Yeah, like imagine your child saying to you that they're just not well and they don't know why they're not well and you can't fix it, no one can fix it. Like, do you know what I mean? Like that burden is huge, and it's something that we subconsciously do not really want to place on our loved ones especially. So I feel like a lot of us make the decision that we're gonna just navigate ourselves and
bottle it, like you said.
Do you know what I mean? Bottle it up and, do you know what I mean, it'll go away and it just ends up coming straight back where it came from, do you know what I mean? So
same kind of thing. You don't want to be judged by people that's kind of been around you all the time. Because they'll even, I'll give you an example. I had a friend who kind of come to our friendship group and said, yeah, man, I'm feeling like this. And instant, people just started backtracking and said, oh, that explains why you did this then, kind of thing. And you could just tell, it just made him feel very small. He kind of wanted support and to let people know that this is why I'm moving away. And he just got bombarded with questions. Because again, like you said, 9 out of 10 people, they just have this mask on. You don't realize. So kind of when it comes to life, you want to know as much information as possible, especially if it's something that you care about. So you're going to be like, rah, how can I help? And personally, for me, when I was going through whatever I was going through, that would have been a nightmare for me. I didn't want anyone in my business. Didn't want to answer no questions on that. So for me, it's just, I know it sounds silly, but I'd rather look weak. I know that sounds bad, but if you was to think I'm weak, I'd rather make strangers think I'm weak, not my people. Then. Obviously, that's not how I see it now. But back then,
that's how it would be.
If I ever had a little opportunity to talk about how I felt, I'd chat to people for time.
Yeah.
If I knew they didn't know anything about me, that I ain't gonna see them next week and they're gonna ask me how am I feeling now, I'll give them everything. But the second I know, bro, this person knows me, I can't chat to this person. And it's a lot of pride, man.
I think right now in time, I think people realize it's actually, you look more stronger of a person by saying it now.
Yeah.
Before, like, I can wholeheartedly say like what you're saying is right. I wouldn't tell another man. It's not your own feeling. Like they're gonna think you're the weak one in the pack. It's like, ooh, bro.
Yeah.
You're gonna get kicked out the pack or whatever. But like right now, like learning and talking to people in general, like it's focused on big older people that like work on mental health and speak to the youth, and they would generally say how they feel and how, and I'm thinking, bro, you're like 40 something, bro, you're telling me how you're feeling, you're upset. I'm thinking, that's a man.
Mm.
That's actually a man.